Hello, friends and neighbors. Welcome once again to another 5 minutes or so with Brother Curtis. Once again, I thought we'd move it inside. There's a little breeze going outside, and I know when a breeze is blowing, it interferes with the sound when you're trying to listen to it. Well, today we're going to look in chapter 24, look at several verses, and what we're going to see today is kind of an illustration of a wise man learning from other people. Remember yesterday, we looked at chapter 23 and verse 26, which said, "My son, give me thine heart and let thine eyes observe my ways." And today we're going to see that observation in progress. And so we find this in verse number 30 is where we're going to start at. Follow along with me if you have your Bible, chapter 24 of Proverbs. It says, "I went by the field of the slothful, and by the vineyard of the man void of understanding. And lo, it was all grown over with thorns, and nettles had covered the face thereof, and the stone wall thereof was broken down." In verse number 32, it says, "Then I saw and considered it well. I looked upon it and received instruction." I believe we can get a pretty good picture of what's going on. I can see maybe King Solomon himself taking a walk as he meditates upon maybe some of his wisdom, maybe it's something he wants to write, something that a proverb that he's going over in his mind. And he comes into a field along the path that he's taking for a walk, and he sees the stone wall is broken down. Now, in our area, you can still see some stone walls they used for fences. We had there at my father's farm, in between our farm and the neighbor's farm, there used to be stone walls that would go down the border of the field that I have no idea how long they would have been there, but eventually they do fall down. And then my father purchased that farm, and then he took those stone walls down and it just made it all one field. But anyway, so you can kind of picture the walls falling down for whatever reason. Could have been just because with settling, they kind of tend to fall off. As you know, the stone walls there were to keep the animals out. They did not have the fences like we do today to keep all the animals in. They kind of roamed, and so those stone walls were built to keep the animals out. And so I'm sure with them pushing against it, but eventually over time, they would just fall. Rocks would be falling out of place and the stone wall wouldn't do much good. And then he looked as well and he saw in the vineyard. And in the vineyard, you expect to see the vines and the grapes where you could pick off and eat. But no, he saw thorns mixed in covering that vineyard, all those vines. And then also the nettles, which would have been the blossoms of the thistles and everything that just covered that vineyard completely. And the Bible says there that Solomon says, he says, "I saw, and then I considered it well. I looked and I received instruction." And see, this is how a wise man learns to live his life. And this is what you and I should be doing. You know, when he saw the wall, he knew that that was a problem to start with, that the person was slothful. You know, they was too lazy. Just go back and pick the stones up. You know, if they just did it one stone at a time, it wouldn't have took that long. But now, I'm sure much of the wall had been torn down, fell over. And so he knew he was slothful. And then he said he was void of understanding. Well, what did he not understand? Well, you know I heard my dad plenty of times growing up there on the farm would say, "You can't grow weeds and corn, because the weeds would always choke out the corn. It wouldn't bring forth any fruit. And so we'd either have to spray or we would till, but we had to get rid of those weeds." And if you have a garden, you understand what happens if you don't care for those weeds. And that's what happened to this vineyard. And so this is what King Solomon was looking at. He considered it. And what was he considering it? What was it that he received instruction from? You know, that word instruction there in the Hebrew has the definition of warning. He was warned that what would happen to a person that was lazy, to a person that just didn't take the understanding. Didn't that person understand that, you know what, if I don't go out and pull the weeds, that them weeds are going to take over my vineyard. And you know, some things Solomon learned was this, and it goes on in the next verse. Two verses says about, well, poverty leads to. Well, slothfulness leads to poverty. That's one thing he learned here. From that person being lazy with not taking care of the fence and not taking care of the weeds, a couple problems he was going to have. Well, he wasn't going to have the fruit that he would have had if he would have kept the weeds out, if he would have kept the cattle out. And now he's going to be begging in time of harvest. And then also, he's going to be begging, but he's not going to have any to eat for himself, but he's not going to have any to sell to take care of his other needs. And so he had learned a lot from someone else's mistakes. And you know, that's what you and I need to do. We need to start looking and considering and gaining understanding of what's going on, receive warning that we want to make sure we don't do in our life. Listen, if we've been going through this book of Proverbs, we've been seeing a lot of different areas about being an angry man, causing strife, words of our mouth, how they hurt. Listen, we see examples of this, maybe not every day, but as we're out, do you not see husbands and wives arguing, people yelling at their kids? Listen, there's a way to handle situations and there's a way not to handle situations. We need to look at it, see it, and then consider it and take warning from it. From what we've learned in the book of Proverbs, from God's word, not just Proverbs, I mean, it's all through the Bible where we can learn. We can learn from the mistakes of the people in the Bible. Listen, we can learn from Solomon, his mistakes, Samson, so many in the Bible that we have for an examples, okay? So, and that's being a wise man. So let's be that wise person and learn from the mistakes of others. Well, God bless you, my friend. I pray you have a great day today. Let's keep praying one for another. God bless you, and you have a great day.